Hello, welcome to the Knives Save Lives channel. I'm here today to do a re-unboxing of the Skill Hunt H03R RC. This is a headlamp that was graciously sent to me by Skill Hunt for review. And this will be the first impressions video of the flashlight. I'll go over some of the specs and things in the sheet. First off, I'll mention that the since I already unboxed it once, it's kind of like a tent or a road map, and it just doesn't go back the same way again, especially after you've put the head straps together. So let's just take a look here real quick. This is a really fascinating headlamp. Okay, so comes in this nice sleeve. That's real beautiful. www.skillhunt.com. Lighting solutions for professionals. Okay, into the box, because I don't do 10-minute box reviews. It came packaged really nicely, like this. There's the lamp. Pull out the foam insert. Underneath there, there's goodies. Okay, I've already put this together for the head strap. First off, I will mention that the head strap is kind of a headache because it took me a while to get this put together. Guys that are more versed in how to use these are probably would find it easy. But yeah, after some trial and error, I got it figured out. So there's that. So put that off to the side. Comes with a lanyard, a pocket clip. This is the same type of pocket clip that comes on a lot of the Olights that I have. Got your paperwork. Comes with spare O-rings. Comes with a little plug here to replace the magnet that is in the tail cap, which I think is really nice. Always like to have a magnetic tail cap, or at least the option. Comes with a charging cable. This is one where you plug it into your power source, USB power source. Then you have this magnetic deal here, and it just sticks right on there, and it charges. It is red while it's charging, and blue when it's done charging. It's pretty nice. Let's get some of this stuff out of the way and take a closer look. So the head strap, actually, before I just toss that to the side, comes with a top strap, which helps to keep this from sagging down into your eyes when you're working or moving around, walking, jogging, whatever the case may be. Here's the flashlight. I'll go over some quick specs off of this sheet here. It comes in Chinese and American. And that's the Chinese side. That is too. See if we can find the English part of it. It is, let's see, it says FL1 standard, T1 is 900 lumens on a 18650, 1000 lumens on a 2 CR123As, 1700 milliamps. 3500 milliamps for the 18650, turbo 2, 490 lumens on the 18650, 500 on the 2 CR123As. It has 365 lumens, 160 lumens, 70 lumens, 20 lumens, 3 lumens, and 0.5 lumens on the 18650, which is what I'll be running in this. You have lower run times with all of the modes on the 2CR123A batteries. It says it has a beam distance of 145 meters. It's 5300 candela. This is IPX8 waterproof and impact resistant to 1 meter. This is instructions for assembling the light, replacing the magnet Then we have the instructions on how to do the head strap. It's got a warranty card here that you can register your warranty with them. A QR code, which is nice. Okay, let's toss that aside. Take a look at the light. This light, I have a Zebra Light H51, I think it is. And I would say that this is very similar in its operation to that. Actually, probably a little better. Let's see. Okay, so it is functioning here. Let's see. So, first off, it does have a lockout mode. Press and hold. It'll come on, then it'll go off. It has an indicator light to let you know that it's locked out for safety. Push the button if you don't want it to keep blinking and draining your battery, and it'll stop blinking red on the switch. This is also the power level indicator for the flashlight. It has certain series of flashes that will do in certain colors to let you know how much battery you've got left on it. It's got a shallow orange peel reflector and a tiny little LED diode in there. Switch is really nice. Nice click to it. It's got some heavy heat sink fins here, and they are deep in there. And it's got some nice square areas on the body. It's got the knurling, which is effective and not too aggressive. It's not something that would grate on your hands like a cheese grater. And that's very nicely done. Let's see, I'll take it open here. Came lubed from the factory. It's got a nice generous O-ring here. I don't know if you can actually make that up, but it's pretty large. Runs on an 18650. I run a Nightcore 3500 milliamp 18650 with 3.7 volts in there. It's got a spring on the inside. And a nice looking PCB, very clean and well manufactured inside. The battery slides in nicely. There's a little bit of space in there, not much. Once you screw the tail cap on, it has a silver coated spring, and that keeps it from rattling while you're working and moving around. There's absolutely no rattle whatsoever. The lens is pretty interestingly installed with this bezel. It has security screws around it. It looks very nice. It's a well-executed design. It has their logo information here, website stuff, and the model number. Let's go through some of the modes on it. To do a shortcut to the turbo, you double click from off. Check it for PWM. It does not look like there's any on that mode. When you're in turbo, you can double click to go to a lower mode of turbo. And each regular mode and even the special modes have secondary levels. So if you want to turn it off, you press and hold to turn it off. If you want to cycle through the modes, you just one press on, and then you just press and hold. You don't press and hold, that turns it off. But anyway, you can just keep single clicking all the way through each mode. Let's check these for PWM. That looks good. Looks good. None there. None there. It's a pretty well done flashlight. Headlamp, whatever you want to call it. So, this is actually the low mode. It looks much brighter on the screen than it actually does to the naked eye. Here's the second level. Or, actually, that's the lowest level of the first low mode. And I want to progress to the next mode. Still no PWM. Double click. I like to keep it on the lowest setting for each mode to preserve battery life. Looks good. There we go. Has memory mode for each one, for each level. And back down to low. Press and hold to turn off. One thing that's great about this is if you triple click, it goes into one of three flashing modes. Here is the beacon mode. Double click again to go into the other beacon mode, which is 1 second intervals. The other one was three. Double click again, it goes into a strobe mode. Strobe mode has two patterns to its beam. It's pretty nice. I like that. That is a really nice touch for this flashlight. I think all flashlights should have strobe mode available. Let's try that again, see if it goes straight back. So it does have mode memory for the special modes as well. Very nice low light level. There was something else I wanted to go through on the run times. It looks like at half a lumen, they don't have the hours listed that the runtime will work for on the 18650 or the two CR123As, but on level one of the three lumen mode on the Firefly mode, it's 450 hours of use for one 18650 at 3,500 milliamp hours. Let's see, 20 lumens is 75 hours, 70 lumens for 25 hours, 160 lumens for 11 hours, 365 lumens for 5 hours, and then the 490 for 3.5 hours. I ran this and tested it to see if it would drop down or if the drop down was noticeable from the turbo mode. It was imperceptible to me, and I ran it for probably 5 or 6 minutes at least, or somewhere around there, and I did not notice that it dropped down at all. It may have, but it was, like I said, pretty imperceptible to my eye. I noticed that even after that, that the head was not hot. It was warm, but it was definitely not hot to where I would be worried about it damaging its internal circuitry. But otherwise, this is just the first look at a newly released headlamp by Skill Hunt. And I think this is a real winner. It's actually pretty lightweight. It's fairly compact. And it rides well on the strap. On your head, it has the pocket clip. It basically comes with all the means necessary to carry it in any way that you'd like to carry it. And I think it's pretty excellent so far. I've actually tried it out for the last couple of days. It's a pretty floody light. It's nice and bright. It's definitely very floody. And I think that's precisely what you'd be looking for if you're looking for a headlamp to go out jogging or go out on walks or walking the dog or, you know, anything of that nature. I'm not sure whether these are safe for mining operations if you're underground with like explosive gases and things like that. I couldn't say, but I would definitely read up on that if I was you, if that was something that you were wanting to look for a headlamp for. But overall, I am highly impressed. I think this is a nice offering by them, and you can look forward to a full review of it in the future after I've carried it and used it some more. And I just want to say thanks for watching, and leave a comment below. Thank you.